G'day and welcome back to Buildsum. And in this video, I just want to go through the difference between a single span beam and a continuous span beam. So the one we're looking at here is a single span beam. And the way we know that is the span of a member supported at or near both ends with no intermediate supports. Okay, so obviously this could be, in this case, it's a bearer for a bearers and joists floor. This is a joist. But it could have quite easily be a brick wall or a pier. It could be a top plate if this was a ceiling joist. It doesn't matter what the beam is in this configuration with supports at both ends and no support in the middle. It's called a single span beam. The other option is a continuously spanned beam or continuous span beam. So similar to the single span, it's supported at or near both ends, but it has additional support in the center. Or anywhere along the length. It doesn't have to be right in the center. And it actually says here that supported at or near both ends and at one or more intermediate points such that no span is greater than twice the other. So as long as this support was not right up at one end, two times, so this was half of or less than half of what the remainder was, then it's continuously supported. If it was, then you'd have to treat them as single span beams. So there's a continuous span beam, and you can have more than one support in the middle. That would still be a continuous span beam. So the advantage of a continuous span beam is because it's continuous over this support, and a bit like the old seesaw effect, the weight of the beam on this side actually helps to support the weight of the beam on this side, and vice versa. And therefore, a continuous span beam can actually span further than the same size beam in a single span configuration. So it's more economical to use beams in a continuous span configuration. And it doesn't have to be supported underneath. We can always support them from above. So if this was a wall plate and a ceiling joist, these could be our hangers supporting our beam from above, so they're hidden in the ceiling. And that would still be considered a continuous span beam. Now, the only place that might change, or the only time that might change, is if we had to cut the beam, right? Say this was a bearer over a pier, and we had to cut it so that we took the bow out of the bearer. We always do that above a support anyway, but obviously that beam is no longer continuous. We've destroyed the structural integrity of that beam at that point. So that in that case, the piece on the end, this would now be a single span beam because it's supported at both ends and no support in the middle, and then the remainder would be a continuously spanned beam. So there you go. I hope that helps to inform you on what the difference is between a single span and a continuous spanned beam.
G'day again, I'm back. Just to let you know, if you like this video, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel or follow me on Facebook so you don't miss out on more great videos.